2010 introduces a lot of new features that are designed to help you create better-looking documents in less time. But how different is it really from previous versions of Word? In this video, we're going to go over some of the new features to let you know what to expect. Word 2007 introduced a lot of really big changes, such as the ribbon interface at the top of the page. The ribbon holds all of the toolbars under various tabs, which some people liked and some people didn't. In Word 2010, there hasn't really been a drastic change to the interface. The ribbon is still here, but there have been some big improvements to it. The first thing is you'll notice the Office button is no longer there, and in its place is the File tab. The File tab takes you to the Backstage view, which is a brand new feature. And here you can find commands such as Save, Open, and Print, and basically anything you would have found in the old File menu, except now you have a nice full-page view of everything. Print Preview is now integrated with the Print command. And there's a page devoted to sharing documents, making it easy to email a document, post it to a blog, or convert it to a PDF file. The other big change to the ribbon is that it's now customizable. This means you can create your very own tabs and add whichever buttons you want. If you want to be able to change the font, add clip art, and spell check your document without clicking back and forth between different tabs, you can now do this with your custom tab. Word 2010 has more powerful photo editing tools than previous versions to help you make professional-looking documents. If you want to add a photo to your document, Word can automatically remove the background, and you can add artistic effects and photo styles to make it look exactly how you want. SmartArt is a feature that was introduced in Word 2007 to help you create visual impact in your documents. And now there are many more templates to choose from. So if you want to create diagrams, timelines, or just any type of graphic to help you convey a point, you can do this with just a few clicks. There are also some new features that make editing easier and faster. If you work with long documents, the navigation pane can help you change the ordering of sections by just dragging and dropping. If you want to paste text, you can now see a live preview so you know what it'll look like even before you paste it. And it's now easier to collaborate using Word's new co-authoring feature, which allows multiple people to edit the same document simultaneously. If you've used Word 2007, then 2010 will be a relatively small change. If you avoided Word 2007 because you didn't like the ribbon interface, you might want to give the ribbon another chance now that they've improved it. Either way, the new features in 2010 can help you be more productive and creative with Word.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.